asked many times what the difference is between a surgical technologist and a surgical nurse. So if you like nursing with that contact with the patient, the direct contact with the patient and the family, and you get that satisfaction of knowing that you've helped somebody, and you have that one-on-one connection, you want to be that surgical nurse. If you get personal satisfaction by knowing that you've helped somebody, but you don't have that direct contact, you want to be a surgical assistant or a surgical technologist, because you are directly associated and working with a surgeon to help that patient have a better outcome. But yet you always don't have the direct contact with the families. And so you're kind of behind the scenes, and you don't always get that acknowledgement. But if you get that inner personal satisfaction of knowing you helped somebody, then a surgical technologist is who you want to be.
About surgical technology through, it was actually one of those shows on TLC or PBS, that the surgery shows, and I was like, I wonder if that's a career field you can do around here. Did an internet search, came up with John Wood had a tech program, and I contacted him and put in my information and got accepted that next year.
I found out that surgical technology was a career by my guidance counselor. I knew I wanted to go into healthcare, but I just didn't know all my options. And this was an option perfect for me because I have a family of three, and it's a shorter program length than some of the nursing programs and radiology and things like that.
What interested me in surgical tech was I wanted to get into the medical field, and I wasn't sure which way to go. And I thought about nursing, but my counselor suggested the surgical tech program. So and I researched it, I looked into it, and it looked like something I would really enjoy. So the process for me when I applied, so I applied for the program, and then I had an interview, and then the second part of the interview was an observation where I got to go to the hospital and stand in on a couple of surgeries, which was really awesome. And then I just, I got a survey in the mail about the observation, and then I turned that in. I waited for the letter to tell me whether I got in or not. After I was accepted into the program, I started on my prereqs. I took microbiology, and I'm getting ready to take anatomy and physiology 1, and in the fall, along with the program, I'll be taking A&P 2.
So during class, like the beginning of the semester, we have lecture and we also have lab twice a week, and it's kind of nice because sometimes we have it here in the classroom, other times we go actually into the OR, so we're able to kind of get that visualization of what we're really going to be doing and where everything's at. So like during lab we go in and actually set up like we're having a procedure done. So like our instructor Kathy has actually gotten onto the OR table, and we've put her up in stirrups, and we've done everything. We set up our instruments and kind of do like a mock procedure, and from start to finish. So it's very nice to kind of get your hands on everything and see all the instruments and kind of go from start to finish, so you know what you're getting into before you actually are standing there by the surgeon.
Every year you have observation and clinicals, usually for the first semester, and you're early on, it's just you coming in and doing what they call it lab. So basically you just kind of learn the very basics, scrubbing in, gowning and gloving sterilely and not contaminating yourself. And then it transitioned into second semester and third semester, you transition into actually going to clinical sites. And then at first, the first couple days, you kind of follow somebody and they say, okay, stand here, do this. But then eventually you start getting hands-on and doing all the cases yourself.
I feel like surg techs are in high demand right now. I have already been offered a job in the main OR. And I know the surgery center also has an opening, and I feel like they're always hiring. They're always needing more help. I think the main OR here at Blessing has 2 trauma ortho surgeons, and so they're constantly needing people to stay over, come in, you know, because you never know when there's, you know, an accident or something. So. Yeah, there's definitely always a need for surg techs.
They said the job outlook is great. They said almost everyone that graduates the program has like multiple job interviews lined up, like job offers. So that made me feel hopeful for the program, and it has such a high success rate too.
I think it was just getting to be hands-on and right there, and you know, it's more of an immediate kind of medicine because, you know, you fix a broken bone and it's fixed, or if you take out a tumor, it's gone. It's kind of instant care, not, okay, well, we're going to see you in 2 weeks and follow up, and it's just more in-depth and hands-on. Scrub techs are important because without them, you can't do surgery. Some facilities will use other people to do that role, but most hospitals now use CSTs to be an integral part of the surgical team. Without scrub techs, you can't do surgeries. You just can't, as a general rule. I mean, there's RNs that can help, but usually it's STs that do that job and set up the cases and pass instruments.
My advice for someone that wants to be in healthcare and they're not sure of kind of what avenue to go, my thinking of the Surg Tech program was, wow, I get to be with some of the most highly intelligent people every day, and you're constantly learning something new. You get to be standing beside a surgeon and have the inside of someone's anatomy in your hand. I mean, you just don't get that in other places in healthcare, and it's that tight-knit family feeling in the surgery room. I definitely feel like there's a lot of room for growth. There are several Surg Tech FAs, which is a first assist, and basically what you do in that role is assist the surgeon in manipulating the instruments and suturing and things like that, which I think is really awesome. So, you know, if you feel like you're kind of stuck as a Surg Tech, that's definitely not the case. And you can also go on to be an RN or, you know, just the FA. After, I think, 2 years of being a Surg Tech, you can go on and become a first assist. And I think that's like a 2 or 3 year program.
Okay. I've done, as far as through my career, I've been a tech now for 12 years. So, well, tech and an FA. Basically, I've done every procedure on every organ and or part of the body except for heart, which I just never got into that specialty, but pretty much everything, because the facility I work at, we don't specialize, so you kind of have to know how to do a little bit of everything. Some other hospitals do specialize where you do just orthopedics or just neurosurgery, but for me, I just like the idea of working somewhere where I got to do everything.
Advice that I would give to someone that's thinking about surgical tech is to research it. Look it up, Google it, just look at all the job duties from beginning to end. And I watched a bunch of videos of people that are surg techs talking about their day-to-day, you know, duties, and that really helped. I mean, that'll make it or break it if you want to do it or not to them.
If you're interested in surgical technology, first and foremost, you can contact somebody at John Wood, and then they can get you set up with an observation day where they'll take you to a facility and let you basically follow one of the instructors, and they will, you know, take you into a room. You actually get to stand in and see a surgery before you ever even join the program. So it kind of gives you an idea of, okay, this might be for me, or I think I'm going to like this, or no, I'm going to do something different. So it's good that right out the gate, you're in before you ever even actually join the program. You're in a surgery suite and you get to see what goes on and what we do. It's definitely a good career to start out in, is being a surgical technologist. There's multiple different fields that you can go into in medicine, but this is a good either first step, or I've parlayed it into a job where I make a fairly good salary for basically anywhere, and it's a nationwide certification, so I could go to California, I could go to basically anywhere and get a job at most hospitals. So it's definitely something that you can parlay into bigger opportunities money-wise, and even going forward you can be a rep for different companies, because once you learn all the products, you know, you become, that's a valuable asset to have for implant companies, all kinds of stuff.